Rukmini's message to Lord Krishna. Sri Sukadev Goswami narrated the history of the marriage of Lord Krishna and Rukmini. Lord Krishna and Balaram went to Dwarka. They heard the message of Rukmini from the mouth of a Brahmana. Krishna chose Srimati Rukmini Devi as his wife. Rukmini, the younger daughter of Bhishmaka, had heard of Sri Krishna's beauty and strength, and she therefore made up her mind that he would be perfect husband for her. But Rukmini's brother Rukmi was envious of the Lord and thus forbade her to marry him. Rukmi wanted her sister Rukmini Devi to marry Sishupal. Rukmini sent a trustworthy Brahmana to Sri Krishna with a letter mentioning the plan to kidnap her. She wrote, "Ever since I have heard about you, my Lord, I have become completely attached to you. Without fail, please come before my marriage to Sishupal and take me away. If you do not shower me this favor, I will give up my life by fasting and observing severe vows." Krishna told the Brahmana to convince Rukmini that very soon he will kidnap and marry her. Since the solemnizing of vows between Rukmini and Sishupal was scheduled to occur only in 3 days, Lord Krishna immediately set out for Vidarbha. Despite the city of Mathura being under attack, Krishna, to protect his devotee, went to Vidarbha. Jarasandh brought a force of 23 Akshanis. Lord Krishna and Balaram ran away and jumped from a mountain known as Pravarshana. On the other hand, preparations were being made for the marriage of Rukmini Devi with Sishupal. The enemies of Krishna, Jarasandh, Salva and Dantavakra, had conspired to kidnap the bride if Krishna came. On the night before the wedding, Rukmini Devi cursed her bad fortune for not seeing Krishna. The Brahmana appeared before her and revealed Krishna's plan of kidnapping her. Krishna and Balaram were honored by the King Bhishmaka along with other guests. Rukmini Devi visited the temple to worship Goddess Ambika along with many guards. She prayed to be allowed to have Sri Krishna as her husband. After worshipping, she held the hand of a friend and walked with deliberate steps when she noticed Krishna. Krishna took Rukmini onto his chariot. He drove back all the opposing kings and slowly made his exit. Jarasandh and other kings, unable to bear the defeat, condemned themselves. As Sri Krishna was taking Rukmini away, the inimical kings gathered their armies and persuaded him. Lord Balaram and the generals of the Yadava army turned to face these opponents, blocking their advance. The enemy armies began pouring incessant showers of arrows upon Lord Krishna's army. Lord Balaram and other heroes then began to annihilate the opposing army with arrows. Jarasandh retreated after suffering the destruction of the armies at the hands of Yadavas. Sishupal returned to his kingdom along with his followers. Being infuriated, Rukmi vowed that he will not enter the palace without his sister. So he set out with his army to attack the Lord in a lone chariot. He approached the Lord, struck him with arrows and demanded him to release Rukmini. Krishna raised his sword high and was about to kill Rukmi when Rukmini interceded and pleased that her brother's life be spared. Krishna did not kill Rukmi, but with his sword he shaved off bits of Rukmi's hair here and there, leaving him disfigured, which is as good as killing him. Lord Balaram pacified Rukmini, saying that the sorry condition of a brother was due to the fruit of his past work, since everyone is responsible for his suffering or happiness. To fulfill his vow of not returning home without conquering Krishna, Rukmi constructed a city on that very spot and took up residence there. Lord Krishna took Rukmini to his capital Dwarka and married her. Everyone was happy to see them united.